band that formed September 27th of 2016. They've come out within the last 3 years with 5 EPs and 1 album.
If I were to explain to someone who is Why Don't We, I would explain it to them that they are 5 amazing best friends.
Why Don't We is a boy band, or as they like to call themselves, a man band. They make pop music and they were formed in 2016 with 5 members,
which is made up of 5 amazing top guys called Jonah Murray, Daniel Seavey, Zach Heron, Corbin Besson, and Zach Avery.
There are 5 really talented guys
that are super talented, super sweet, and very kind. They are extremely kind to the Limelight family, which is us.
They started their band 3 years ago in September.
They've grown so much in the past 3 years.
Their personalities are just amazing, and they care so much about us. Like, in my opinion, I haven't met a boy band that's like been that supportive, but like they care about their fans so much, and I love that about them.
They're super sweet and like super generous to us. Like, they do a lot of things that they technically don't have to do, but they're amazingly sweet. They are really authentic. You can tell from just them being them. Like, they were friends before the boy band, so you can see the real friendship of them, because with other boy bands it's a little bit forced with other boy bands, because some of them were forced in. Some of them don't even choose to be in the one, some are just forced in. But with them, it's really original, really authentic, and really them. You can tell they want to be a boy band, and they really want to be them. And it's very amazing to be a part of this family.
Like, if you're upset or something, he can make you smile in like a second. He started off on You Now before he joined Why Don't We, and he got his popularity from there. He posted his first singing video when he was 14.
Daniel Seavey is a 20-year-old from Portland, Oregon. He started off his music career by busking on the streets of Portland and then auditioning for American Idol. He made it pretty far. He actually made it all the way to the live rounds and then got voted out on his birthday, which kind of sucks, but it all worked out for the best, because shortly after that, he joined Why Don't We, and as the rest, you know, is history.
Jack Avery is 20 years old and in the very popular boy band Why Don't We. I don't know where to begin to describe Jack. He is so goofy and talented. His smile and laughter will light up any room he walks into, and you can't help but smile and laugh with him because it's so contagious. The love he gives to his fans and family, and especially his daughter Lavender, is so beautiful.
Jonah Murray is a 21-year-old from Stillwater, Minnesota, that got his rise of fame from posting YouTube and You Now videos of him singing his own songs and cover songs.
Zach Heron is an 18-year-old from Dallas, Texas. He got his start posting videos of himself singing online. He had a video of himself singing Stitches by Shawn Mendes go viral, and then he joined some social media tours to help grow his fan base. He joined Why Don't We, and they all joined forces, and he's also one of the goofiest people I've ever met, but also one of the sweetest, and he has one of the biggest hearts.
The word Limelight means spotlight, and they used it in their first ever recorded song, Taking You.
A Limelight is someone who is a huge fan of the man band, Why Don't We?
The fans were named Limelights because they were there from the very beginning.
Why are the fans called Limelights?
9 months into them first forming, they were at a Q&A, and they got asked, does your fan base have a name? The boys were kind of speechless, and all they had to say was, no, we do not, but we'd like to send out a message to our fan base, like telling them that we can come up with our own name and that make ourselves known.
The name Limelights actually came from the fans.
So their first song, Taking You, the first line.
The first line.
First line.
I need you in my life like Limelight.
And I need you in my life like Limelight.
And all of the fans added hashtagging, we are Limelights.
So then a couple of the fans picked that up and used it as our fandom name, and now we are called Limelights. Like, every artist has a name for their fans, and that's ours. And definition of being in the limelight, I suppose, is the center of attention. So we're like the center of attention for the boys.
It's nice and unique rather than just calling your fans fans.
What makes someone a limelight?
Anything to do with the boys, like supporting them, hyping up their music, just being there for them, just all those things, like supporting the artists that they are.
Don't have to buy merch and go to the concerts to be a limelight. I just think that you need to support other limelights and you support the boys 110% because, you know, like they've like helped so many people with stuff. They've helped like my friends with like everything. They've helped me with stuff. And I feel like they're really, the music's really good and like relatable, if you know what I mean. I've made so many friends with being a limelight. And when I went to the Auckland show, the Last Eight Letters tour show in Auckland, New Zealand, it was amazing. Like I met so many friends and I had such a blast. And I think they just like show that anyone can do anything. They don't listen to other people.
A limelight should love the boys no matter what, but a limelight should also be there for the other fans. They should hype them up if they're seeing them in concert, and they should help them throughout anything they're going through. But more importantly, a limelight should support the boys and their music.
What makes someone a limelight is making tons of new friends, be kind to each other, and having great times at the shows.
For me, like a real limelight is someone who supports the boys in any possible way. I think really important, someone who loves and streams their songs and supports their music.
Someone who is considered a limelight is somebody who genuinely cares about the boys, wants to see them succeed, listens to their music, and sticks by them no matter what happens.
What makes you a limelight is, you know, supporting these guys. Yeah, and always being there for them and, you know, just with them no matter what, you know. So that's what being a limelight is.
What are some of the biggest stereotypes about being a fangirl?
What are some of the biggest stereotypes? People assume that we commit everything to them and that we would do anything in our right minds for them. But like the reality of being a fangirl, we just love and support them. We're like everyone else, but we have a part of us that is just appreciation for these people, for doing what they do, making music, interacting with us.
Some of the biggest stereotypes based on a fangirl are that we only care about this one thing, we do not care about anything else in our life, that we're completely obsessed, don't think or want to talk about anything else. These are completely false. I can tell you that being a fangirl is so much more than that.
I feel like for the big stereotypes of being a fangirl is that we're like crazy or stalkers, or I don't know. Usually when I feel like people who aren't fangirls hear that, they think we're these crazy obsessed people who like all we do all day is stalk Why Don't We, and obviously that is not the case whatsoever.
So some stereotypes that are based around fangirls is that you're pretty much overly obsessed with that band or person. I don't think just because you're a fangirl you're overly obsessed. So yes, you could be, but main people, they just like their music, so they have their merch. They go to concerts and stuff. It makes you a fangirl because you really like their music or what they do. There's some people who think you're like obsessed, you aren't gonna let it down if you're a fangirl, but that's just a stereotype. Just because you like someone doesn't mean that you're overly obsessed.
I'd say some stereotypes are that we're constantly crying and screaming and uncomposed and all this other stuff, but in reality, we're pretty calm when we see the boys. We're just enthusiastic for the boys, and we want to make them feel loved and appreciated and all this other stuff.
The biggest stereotype around being a fangirl. Oh, simple. When people think of fangirls, they think of people who are completely and utterly obsessed with a certain person or group. They're usually think about, let's say, early teens, and those people are enthralled in the band or in the who the people are, to the point where it'd be crazy or obsessive. Some people can be like that, I will agree, but not always.
I think one of the biggest misconceptions as being a fangirl is that you're obsessed, you're crazy, you're a nobody and you don't belong and like you're just stupid. Like I've gotten that so many times, but like, you know, like a lot of people assume that you're just some girl that's obsessed over these guys or a girl, but in this case guys. and you pray that you're going to marry them and all that stuff, but like it's not like that at all. It's just simply enjoying their music and watching them grow up and watching them go on stage and love what they do genuinely and love doing it and love performing, and they love their fans. Like this Limelight family especially, like it's just crazy because the fandom is different too. But fangirls have a stereotype and I really want to break it, so yeah, we're not crazy, we're not obsessed, we're not crazed teens, whatever, we're family. And yeah,
most people think that being a fangirl is just like stupid and you're just like over some boys, you'll never meet them, you know, like they think it's just stupid, which is really not. It's something that we're very passionate about, and these boys, they saved like a lot of people from suicide and stuff, so it's really not stupid, and it's really not what they think. People like see me as a fangirl, especially boys from school, they keep making fun, you know.
Some of the biggest stereotypes is that we're all 12 years old and we're all little girls that are overly obsessed with a boy band. They always think we're so obsessed for them for their look. We really just love them for their music and everything else they do.
In my opinion, like typical fangirl stereotypes is obviously like the most common fangirl stereotype that probably everyone thinks what we are is like this little young screaming girl standing in front of a concert stage thinking that every Wattpad fanfiction might come true. They spot us in the crowd, we gonna get taken backstage, and then we fell in love and live a happy life. Then also I think most people think that like fangirls are the ones who, when they actually get the chance to meet their favorite or the person they're fangirling over, probably just faint in front of them. Thinks a fangirl is literally someone who's in the age of like 14 or 15, 16 years old, and they're like these young high school girls fangirling over a boy who's probably twice their age or something, or a lot older than them. But I think that's also not true, because some of them are actually like older and not like all these little girls.
I feel like the biggest stereotypes of being a fangirl is that you buy all the merch, you go to all their shows, you stalk them.
What is it actually like to be a fangirl?
What is it actually like to be a fangirl? Well, being a fangirl, we are not crazy, first of all. I am a big fangirl. I'm 21 years old and I am a fangirl. Why don't we? I am not ashamed to say that whatsoever. I'm very proud of myself for liking them because they're cool. But being a fangirl to me is obviously you're there to be passionate and love the people you're listening to. That can be just anything from being a fangirl. For me personally, I fangirl to them while I'm like listening to their music, supporting them when new songs come out or when they have shows, just whatever it may be, just like you're always there supporting them and loving what they're doing and like giving them the amazing feedback, because obviously they're working so hard for us to make all this great music. And then like obviously, like I know artists say like, oh, without, like if you're at a show or something, always like artists are like, oh, without you guys, like none of this would be possible. But it's literally true. Like you can have an amazing voice and sing good, but the moment you have those people there supporting you, I feel like it just makes everything so worth it too, because they're working so hard and they're just doing this. And obviously, since there's so many fangirls, it just makes it worthwhile, because they know there's people out there really enjoying what they do, and like they can make people happy and obviously change people's lives too, because I've seen it multiple times where people always say, like fangirls will talk about Why Don't We, and they're like, oh, they changed my life or they saved my life. And I think that's really meaningful and really special, the impact artists can do to you in general. It's like really bringing everyone together, and it just, you make so many new friends and everything. And it's really cool. I love it. A lot of my friends that I have today that I consider my best friends, I have met from being a fangirl of Why Don't We. And I love that.
But what it's really like, I mean, for me, my experience has been quite good. I haven't come into any rude limelights or anything. So, and it's really nice to just like scroll through Instagram and see all of the people making their edits and wallpapers and stuff. It's so cool to see how much support is behind the boys and how much they like serve to the boys. I hope it makes them happy, honestly. They deserve the world.
Being a fangirl is probably one of the best things I have ever done in my life, and I honestly think that it's given me so many opportunities, including just simply listening to music and just finding happiness within it, but also as well as meeting friends and being able to actually meet them in real life and creating a family. Like, it's great, and people see fangirls as crazies and nobodies and people who just don't belong. I mean, it sucks, like, it does. And on the other hand, like, they're great. Like, I don't know, I love being a fangirl, and I think that people need to realize that's more than just obsessing over a celebrity or whatever.
What is it actually like being a fangirl? And it's pretty fun. We do projects like this one. We help them promote their music as well as they do. We make them happy. We always support them no matter what they're going through or doing.
Being a fangirl is really amazing. Like, why don't we? They just changed my life like 360 degrees. Sure, they took all my storage, all my time, but like, for all the parents who think, you know, they're just gonna, like, you know, waste your time, and especially my conservative parents who really are think that studying is super important, they really don't, you know. They just, you know, they make my day. I just love, like, opening my phone after a long hectic school day and just look at their stories, tour shows, extra. Like, they make my day, and being a fangirl has gained me so much internet friends, and I'm so thankful for that. I have a fan page, and I have gained so much friends through that, and I'm so thankful and grateful for each friend.
To be a fangirl is to not be obsessed with people, but to support them in every way you can. Celebrating their successes, commiserating their losses, like, to bring them up when they're low. That's what I think being a fangirl is, or being a fan in general. It's to support the people that could have helped you through anything in life. The amount of people that I talk to through my fan account who have had issues, and the band has helped them through that without knowing it. Like, it's the same with me. It was them that helped me through the darkest part of my life. And I think there's a lot of fans like that, where being a fangirl, fanboy, fan in general, is like, it's like they're a part of you, they're a part of who you are. They connect you with people from all across the world who have the same interests as you. You meet people that you never thought you'd meet, or that you never thought you'd connect with.
What it's like being a fangirl, just support the artists we love. It's just so much joy and happiness. We met like the best friends ever. Struggling about time zone is probably the biggest thing ever, because you usually never like in the same time zone as the people you actually love, and being a fangirl is much more than anything everyone else expected to be. Sometimes it's not even like possible to show that it's so much more, because sure, we all go like into these typical stereotypes that we have, like running an Instagram fan account or running like a fan account on Twitter. We're always like on our phone trying to check updates. We always want to meet our idols. We always want to thank them, but also we're just like normal people. We're not crazy. You're like not always into the artist. Sometimes you're also really into the music, and this music just gives you so much strength and so much happiness and helps you to get through so many things.
Being a fangirl is actually really fun. I've made friends from all over the world. A lot of times, for some people that don't really fit in school, getting a fan account or like having an idol at least makes you fit in with some people. It makes you feel included.
Why do you think some fangirls are considered to be stalkers?
Some people do go to extreme lengths to do it, but majority of us wouldn't, because there's boundaries. We've all learnt them, because at the end of the day, they're normal people like us that just have a following.
I don't think being a fangirl is a stalker whatsoever.
I don't think just by being a fangirl you're a stalker. I think you would have to do way more than just like find out, oh, they posted on Instagram, oh, they posted on Halogen, they posted on Twitter. I think it's more than that. I think you have to like follow them and find out their addresses, their phone numbers without them physically giving it to you, because at that point you're just invading privacy, and that's kind of what a stalker is. It invades your privacy. So I think until like, and if you make them uncomfortable, you don't want to make them uncomfortable, because then it's just, you're kind of making them uncomfortable, as I said, and it's just not fun for anyone.
I don't think it makes you a stalker. It really, there's a fine line between stalking and supporting, and some people just really don't know that fine line. But the boys really don't mind it at the same time. They mind it when you're being a stalker, but when you're really just there for them and being enthusiastic and like just caring for them in general, they really don't mind it.
Being a fangirl is definitely not a stalker. Sure, I'll go through their Instagram feed, like just scroll and scroll, but that's just because they're cute, okay? Like, don't judge me. I am not a stalker, and I respect the boys' privacies 100%. Like, even if like they make music for us and stuff, like they have their own personal lives.
I really hate the term stalker and stalking them and stuff like that, because that's not what it is at all. Like, a lot of girls especially like get made fun of for constantly checking their social media pages, like their idols' social media pages and stuff like that. But it's not stalking, it's just checking up on them. Like, if I'm on my phone, I'm checking on them, and just people are always like, stop stalking them. Like, it's not a stalking, it's just checking up and to see if they posted anything new or added to their Instagram story or whatever. Like, it's just, I think using the word stalking is going a bit too far.
Some girls always be like considered, when they're a fangirl, they're also considered as a stalker. And in my opinion, that's not true at all. Now, stalking for me is like actually following someone everywhere they go and always being with them. And stalking also for me comes with like a bad intent that they usually stalk someone because they're like crazy over them and just maybe want to hurt them or want something bad for them. But that's definitely not what a fangirl wants. A fangirl usually just wants to get the chance to meet their favorite for one time, at least like one time, just to thank them and tell them how grateful they are for everything they've done for them. But usually not like stalking around just because, yeah, we want to know everything about them or what we think we actually got a chance with them.
How far have you traveled to see a show?
I've been to two shows. I've been to the Barcelona one last year, and that was 6-hour drive. And I've been to Birmingham. It's 2.5-hour flight from where I live.
We've gone to New Mexico, Colorado, Las Vegas, Arizona, Utah, San Diego, and Vegas again. And we loved every single one of them.
The longest I've ever traveled for a show would be New York, but I'd rather talk about Tilburg as it was a part of a tour and it took me a week to get there.
We've traveled to a few different places for shows.
Yes, especially this year.
Yeah, we've been to Vegas, we've been to California, went to Portland.
Seattle. And then I went to Australia. I also went to New York for an invitation tour.
I live in Vancouver, Canada, and the farthest I've gone for a show was actually for my very first show and the only show I've ever been to, sadly. But I took a road trip to California with my parents.
What made you decide to travel to that destination?
My dad had given me a gift card, kind of a gift card for 6 of the shows on the 8 Letters tour with 4 VIPs. Yeah, that's why we went there.
We chose to travel to the destinations that we did because, well, they weren't coming to Vancouver. Yeah. So we had to go see them somewhere else.
And all of the shows like Seattle and Portland were pretty close to us, and then going to California, we got to go to Disneyland and stuff and just got to see one of her older roommates. I went to New York because I wanted to go see their show again, because and there was 3 nights and I was like, might as well go to one of the ones with 3 nights. And then I went to Australia because I used to live there.
It just so happened that the boys were going to be in California the same time we were, so it worked out perfectly, and I really believe that the stars aligned for that. I went to the show alone, but I was meeting up with a bunch of my internet friends, which was very exciting to meet them all for the first time. It was at the State Fair.
We didn't really have a main reason we wanted to travel to any of these places, like San Diego, Vegas. Well, her mom lives in Vegas, so we went to the Vegas show. She lived in New Mexico, so we went there. But Utah, Arizona, and Colorado, there wasn't really a main reason we wanted to go. It was just, why not? Because, I mean, we're young, we love traveling, and we figured why not? We might as well just do it. And all these shows were close enough to each other, so we made it work. It worked good timing. My work schedule, just with whatever she's got going on.
The Barcelona one, because I went to that destination because it's closest to me. I went to the Birmingham one because I got to see my family, my grandparents and cousins, that I haven't seen in about 3 years. So it was really good to catch up with them and go to an amazing concert.
Have you had any memorable experiences while traveling?
As I said, we went from Copenhagen to Tilburg, so when the boys had a day off, so did we. And we decided to go to a mall in Utrecht. And as soon as we entered the mall, I see Corbin and Daniel and Jonah and Eben and some of the crew. They were like all there. Like as soon as I saw them, as soon as they like saw me, they started waving at me. And that was crazy because that meant that they recognized me from some of the previous shows. But I went in and I talked to them. Then I left them alone because I wanted to give them some privacy.
We've had both good and bad experiences. We've had amazing memories and made so many fun things happen. But we've had some bad things happen, like missing flights almost. And almost missing... Well, Greyhounds leaving us in the middle of California.
That was a rough one.
That was fun. We may have gotten stranded in the middle of Barstow, California, and had no way of getting anywhere without taking a Lyft, which there was one Lyft driver in the entire city, and he was about to go to bed.
He was awake. We almost didn't get that.
Yeah, so we've had some interesting experiences.
But I'd say that the good experiences we have definitely outweighed the bad experiences.
Yeah, and we would do it again in a heartbeat. 100%. Oh yeah. And
as soon as they announce the next tour, we're gonna go to more shows again.
In Colorado, we brought our friends Caitlin and Kaylee with us. That was like our second time meeting. Actually, we met at the New Mexico show.
The way we traveled there was in my mom's Jeep. So it took about 20 hours, I believe, which is a very long time. And we did break it up into sections, so we weren't just driving straight there. I didn't have anything really prepared, honestly, for the show. I didn't have an outfit plan, so I was panicking the day before trying to go through my luggage of a few outfits to figure out what I could wear, and it was very stressful.
Why do you do it?
I have a lot of reasons, but one of them is that I discovered the boys at a very hard time in my life. They helped me so much back then, and they helped me through every day. Now, like every time life gets hard, they can get me through it somehow, and I'm so thankful for that. Like, I can't even thank them enough for that. Also, just seeing them in person and seeing them perform and hearing the music live that has kept me going the last couple of years, that's just so amazing. And they're so great performers. I disappear into a whole other world when I'm at the shows, and I can see everybody's just having the time of their lives. And just seeing the boys happy makes me so happy, and seeing them living their dreams inspires me so much to go after mine. Also, just like the fact that they actually remembers me, and I see them recognize some other fans too, that's like a big part of it for me, that they actually see the fans. They're not just like hi and then move on. They're like actually okay, hi, and then they remember the person. If they see the person again, they like actually see us. They're not just like okay, she's just a fan. They're like okay, she's supporting us, and they appreciate the fans. Yeah, I feel like they make every single person in the crowd feel loved and feel so special. And I always have something to look forward to, because even now I don't know when they're going on tour again, but I'm already saving up so that I have something to look forward to, because sometimes I really need to disappear into my why don't we world. And yeah, I can do that from home with their music too, but really their concert is my happy place. I can't wait to go to a show again.
It was just a lot of fun. It's all worth it, because in the end you're having a really fun experience, and you're going to see these five boys who you normally see through a screen. They're like the sweetest, most humble, nice, supportive, caring people. It's their personalities that make it so worth going again and again, because you get to go meet these guys who support you and give you so much like hope and love for like so many things, so much of what you're going through, that it just makes you want to keep going. Going on these tours have brought so many amazing memories. I have people all the time tell me, don't go to these concerts, don't do it, it's not worth it. It really is. I wouldn't trade any of them for the world, because I've been going through the hardest times, and being at these concerts will just make you feel so carefree, like nothing else is happening in the world. I've met so many of my best friends today, some of which who are doing this project. I'm just so thankful, because these are people who I talk to now every day and make me feel so much different, and we talk about meeting and doing all this, and I've gotten to meet so many of them through this as well, through being a limelight, because this band just brings so many people together.
I traveled to the show because the boys weren't really coming anywhere close, and I've always wanted to see them, and a bunch of my internet friends were going to that show, so I wanted to make sure that I was there and could see them. Timing just worked out really well for that, and I'm so grateful that I got to experience that and got to go out of the country to California, one of my favorite places, to see my favorite band perform. And it was just a really cool experience, and I'm very thankful for it.
What makes it worth it to me is making all the memories and meeting all the friends that you meet along the way. Like, I've met so many friends, and I've gotten so much closer with her and like our other friends just because we decided to travel and go to a show. Like, it's incredible.
Yeah, I've made so many more friends this year just from going to shows and hanging out with people at the shows. I'd rather spend my money on experiences rather than materialistic things.
These concerts just make people happy, and I think that's what makes it worth it the most, is the happiness you get from getting the tickets and seeing the show live and just experiencing it all in person.
Oh my god! Lauren, stop. Stop!
No, she's crying because they're laughing, and I'm laughing. I'm crying because she's laughing at the moment.
What is it?
Why don't we? You're going. Why don't we?
Yes.
Well, I figured if you're going, why not him?
That's what's this?
Read it.
You're going to see the concert.
But it's not even that big of a deal.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my.
Why can't you cry?
There's something on the top up there. What is that?
Oh god! It's not the face again! She returns! Why?
What are we crying for? Why don't we?
It's tickets!
Why don't we cry anyway?
Yeah, that's what she does. Why don't we cry?
I guess my password. And it
was
amazing.
Why do I do it? I do it because, first of all, it's really good concerts. Like, the performance that the boys put on is amazing. And concerts itself are, like, really fun. Like, the energy is so good. The vibe is amazing. And it's really good to see the boys pursue their career. It's amazing to watch, to see how small of a crowd they used to have and now how big they are now, and they're gonna get even bigger, and it's just an amazing experience, and I plan on going on many more concerts. And yeah,
I was just so enthralled by the whole experience, like concert after concert, and the whole touring thing. Like, it was so foreign to me before I'd gone and seen that other people had done it, but I understand why. It's like addicting. It's so much fun, and it's crazy. It's literally so fun, and somehow when you get one good thing after another like that, it's just, it's worth all the the traveling and, I don't know, just experiences, I guess. I've gotten in trouble for driving to Atlanta, but it was so worth it. Like, I'm doing it again for a Jingle Ball, and I'm hyped. Like, it's gonna be a great time. I'm not even upset about it, dude. Yeah, it was a lot of fun, and I wouldn't take it back. And I'm gonna probably keep doing it for a while and go broke, because they're worth it. They're a lot of fun. And every show is different in some way or another. We always pop off. It's worth it.
Are the boys any different in person than they portray online?
Are they different in person? It's a funny question, because I feel like, as someone who's met them a few times, it's really something. They do act a little different, but it's not in a bad way. It's like, when you first start meeting them, they're trying to act genuine, like, hey, I really care about you, like, what's your name, how are you, how are you doing? And then as you start to meet them more times, it kind of becomes a more friendly relationship where you start joking around and you get to see that funnier side of them, and that's kind of what I experience.
Are they different in person than they are in real life? 100% no. The only different thing about them is that they keep their private lives private, obviously, because private. But people always think that, oh, famous people, they always have like a different side of them, like they're two-faced. But for them, that's not the case. They're the most genuine, humble people that I know. And yeah, it's always a blast hanging out with them.
When I met them, they were really sweet and caring, and they were all like, I love you. They were all goofing around. Jack was just casually blowing bubbles in the back, and Daniel was just running around and waving at everyone in the queue. So no, I don't think that they act different in real life than that we see them on social media.
Are they different in person than they are in real life? I'd have to say no, because you see how funny and sweet they are in like the interviews and the Instagram stories. And whenever I met them, they were the exact same. They were super funny and super sweet.
What was it like meeting them for the first time?
When I got into the line, I was so excited, like my heart was racing. When I met them, I froze in front of Daniel. He said I was adorable, that he loved me. I hugged him so tight. I accidentally called Jonah Jojo Vidababo. Yes, I called Jonah Jojo Vidababo. He laughed and we took the phone to him outside this. They were so nice. Don't cry.
Last year in December, it was on December 5th, I believe, at Kissmas, was the first time I saw them. And I had barely known who they even were then. And after that, I just became a really big fan. And when their tickets went on sale in March, I bought tickets and got Limelight for Louisville. And that was the first time I met them. And it was, first of all, it was surreal. Like, I went with my friend Logan. When the boys came out, they kind of like walked down this set of stairs. They kind of walked straight towards us. I remember Corbin walked directly towards us because they all broke off and like everywhere. And Corbin walked directly towards me and Logan. My heart literally dropped. I was like, oh, I wasn't expecting it. That was so amazing. I got to meet all the boys and I got to talk to all of them like individually, and I have so many great memories from that day.
For the first time, I was very nervous and very like scared, and I don't know why, but it was amazing and it was one of the best days of my life.
What was it like meeting them for the first time? I actually met Corbin, Daniel, and Jonah for the first time outside of the venue. I have to say that I was pretty anxious and nervous about that, because they are the reason that I smile every day and that I keep going. So it was a pretty big deal for me to meet them. So yeah, I was nervous and anxious, but after all, it was a really good experience because they made sure I was comfortable. They started the conversation because I think they noticed that I was nervous. After I met them and I went home, I was like, why was I so nervous? Why did I act like that? It's pretty obvious because they are the sweetest human beings on this earth, so.
What's it like meeting them for the first time? So, in my situation, I haven't met them, like Limelight or VIP, but I have seen them multiple times, a lot of times, at their concerts, and it's very different from meeting them in Limelight and VIP. It's just very different because seeing them doing what they love to do and them being so involved with the fans is something that is very different from, you know, just hugging them, taking a picture, and, you know, talking with them. It's very different. I can say that. But doing what they love to do and you just seeing it and watching them enjoy it and getting to the songs, it's crazy.
I just met the boys for the first time this summer. They were the absolute most sweetest human beings ever. I didn't really expect anything else from them. They're just so sweet and they're so nice and everything. And they were also a whole lot shorter than I was expecting. And when I met them, I had so many butterflies in my stomach. Like, they were literally right there in front of me and I could actually touch them. Like, they were right there.
Are there any funny or memorable stories of you and the boys?
I have met Corbin a couple times. The last time I met him was in October. I was there with a few other people and everyone was handing him ducks, like little plastic ducks. It was pretty funny to watch his reaction and what he had to say to it.
Probably Radio City. I'll never forget that show. It was the venue that sold out in 15 minutes, which it's crazy. I can't get over that. It was insane because, number one, all their family, friends were there to support them. And Corbin dreamed of performing there one day, and he did. He took a picture in front of the venue, like, a while back, like, years ago. And now he was saying that, like, followed his dream.
The first time I saw them live, Jonah, he was off to the side of the stage. There was a water bottle by his microphone. So he picks up the water bottle instead of the microphone and he tries to start singing to that. And he even said, like, after the song was over, he even said that it was one of his funniest moments that, like, happened on stage.
I had a water bottle over there and I, like, accidentally started singing into the water bottle instead of the mic. Yeah, I was like, I was singing my harmony into the water bottle.
I hope someone has a video of that. Please make it go.
How many shows have you been to?
I have been to three. The Invitation Tour, the Eight Letters Tour, and the Eight Letters Summer Tour.
I have been to three shows. I've seen them on the Invitation Tour, the Eight Letters Spring Tour, and the Eight Letters Summer Tour.
I've only ever been to one Wide Open concert. Got my ticket here. Absolutely loved it.
I only have been to one concert in October.
I've been to two Wide Open shows, both in Arizona. I was gonna go to Jingle Ball this year. I didn't get tickets, really bummed out, but hopefully I can see them next time. I haven't traveled out of state, but I really hope to sometime.
What's your favorite song to see performed live?
I love Hard and Into Deep because they're just the slower songs. I love those too. They're just really nice and I love them in concert.
My favorite song to see performed live is either I Don't Belong in This Club or Trust Fund Baby.
My favorite song to see performed is definitely I Don't Belong in This Club, just because the boys are really fun when they do that. You know, they do their trumpets with the microphone. And then having Macklemore, like, on the video is really cool.
I can't choose. I have Choose, Friends, Into Deep, Runner, Why Don't We Just, Mashups, Eight Letters, and One Am I, but I can't choose, like.
My favorite song that they performed was either Choose, just because the dancing, the song is just good, it's great to sing along. Also, What Am I, because What Am I had just come out quite recently before the concert. They were playing it with their instruments, and it was just like,
what's your favorite concert memory?
This last concert, the summer tour, I got to meet their moms and their sisters and their brothers and all that. And they are just so genuinely, like, sweet and amazing and caring that, like, it's amazing to me. And, like, I don't know. That was just, like, one of the best moments because I really, like, loved meeting them. And I have the picture of me meeting them back there. Anyway.
Some of my favorite concert memories are getting to see my friends that I've made at past concerts. I really enjoy seeing them.
One of my favorite memories from the concert was the black and white video of them writing letters and the music playing in the background to Eight Letters instrumentally, and the whole crowd was just like singing Eight Letters, and it was, I don't know, it was just a real moment where I felt like all those limelights were sort of together.
One memory that really sticks out to me was I went to their Arizona show this year in March, and I met them, first time meeting them, and I also met my IBF, internet best friend. We were FaceTiming and texting all the time, and then we lived in the same state, but we never met up because we lived different parts of the state, and she came to the show, and I went to the show, and we both met up, and we just had an amazing time, and it was so much fun.
What are the pros and cons of going to a show?
Good things is you meet so many cool people. If you put yourself out there and just talk to them, like the people around you, you will have such a better experience at the concert because so many cool people, and it's so amazing. And I know it could be like a little hard to like just talk to people, but if you see anyone, just like talk to them and like get to know them more throughout the concert, because it'll just have like a way better experience. Some bad things: some people can judge you a little bit, especially parents. I think like when you're at a concert, like screaming and all that, some parents do give you dirty looks, and some people give you dirty looks because they think it's annoying. But just like don't let anyone ruin your experience, because it's such a great experience, and like don't let anyone ruin it. Like, just ignore them. Another bad thing is like the merch lines can kind of get unorganized, and some people push and cut. So just like kind of wait, and everyone's gonna get their merch, like, you know. So just like, yeah.
Some good things about the concerts is that you get to either reunite with your friends that you've made or meet new people and create friendships through the concerts and stuff like that. Some bad things is that if you're claustrophobic and you're in the pit, it's not gonna be the best experience. From personal experience, it's not the best experience.
Some good things about concerts is you get to see your favorite performer live, and it's just so fun, especially if you're doing it with friends. Like, if you have friends, you're gonna have an amazing time, and you just like get to sing all the words without anyone judging you, because they all like the same person as you, whereas your siblings might not. Some bad things about concerts are it's really loud, and sometimes you can't hear as much as you would like to. It's not just like putting in headphones and listening to the song. And another bad thing is like sometimes you don't always get the seats you want because they're selling out so fast. Like, I was really lucky, I got like the fifth row back in the Arizona show this year, but we were like right on the site when the tickets went up and they were going out really fast.
What's your favorite part about seeing a show live?
I think just like seeing them like and how far they've come, because I started listening to them from the beginning, like, you know, 2016. And so just like seeing how far they've come and like all that, it's like truly amazing. And to see like they do this for us because they want to see us happy and they truly care about us is so amazing. And just like the overall vibe of it, it's like it's so amazing just to see a concert live, because it's so much different from like watching a video on your phone, and it's just so much different. And like, definitely live in the moment when you're there. Don't try and like record everything. I mean, obviously like record if you want, but like, you know, definitely like live in the moment, because it's so, so fun.
But my favorite part is about seeing a live show, seeing my favorite songs performed live and through a different experience and through stage production. I love seeing stage production when they put work into like the choreography, the visuals, the outfits, everything. I love seeing all of that.
Just seeing them perform and doing their dances and stuff, it's so cool.
What was the fan project you were a part of?
The fan project was Rainbow Hearts, which red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and purple. And instead of just having the colors scattered around all over the venue, I decided that I wanted to make it in sections. So, for example, Orchestra 1 was red, Orchestra 2 was orange, Orchestra 3 yellow, 4, you get the gist of it.
This fan project blew tape on flashlights during It Too Deep.
The fan project I took part in was for 8 Letters Tour Chicago.
So I've actually created 2 projects, one with her and one was, I mean, kind of on my own, but kind of she also helped.
Helped a little bit.
So the first one that I did was for the Invitation Tour, and it was for the Vancouver show in March of 2018. I made signs that said, "You are cordially invited to Vancouver," and it was like plan words for like the whole invitation thing. And we all held it up when the boys sing Invitation.
And then we did one for the 8 Letters Tour. We held up a sign that said, "This is a forever thing," during Taking You. So
this was for the Seattle show on the spring tour.
Why did you create the fan project?
We had started this fan project because we had seen so many people do it on Instagram, and like we just really wanted to show our love, I guess, and show them that Denver, that we cared about them, and we thought this would be like a good way to portray it, I guess.
We decided to create a fan project because we thought it was something that would not only make the boys happy, but just would be really cool to see.
Making a fan project, you get to work together with a bunch of other people who share the same interests as you, and we made so many friends making it too.
I was put in a group chat with about 11 other girls, and we all cut out little bags full of yellow tissue paper in the shapes of squares or hearts. After Eben performed, we would pass them all out. There was a note written on the bag saying what to do with them. And when 8 Letters came on, we all put them over our flashlights and just shined them and waved them around.
The goal was just to show the boys our love and appreciation for them. Before the show, girls that coordinated it had stacks of paper that said Chicago loves you, and it had the logo, and it just looked so, so cool to see everybody holding up these papers and to show our love for the boys.
Why did I create this fan project? I created this because I had seen in past stops, the tour had already started by the time that me and the Why Don't We Louisville group chat that I was in thought of this. And I had seen that on previous stops that during the song In Too Deep, a lot of the fans were holding up like little hearts or signs and then putting their flashlight through them and making the venue look absolutely beautiful and stunning. And one of them really stood out to me, which was, I don't remember exactly which stop it was, but it was Purple Hearts, and it was for Lavender, Jack's baby. I saw that and I was like, I want to do something really like that.
How did you make the project happen?
So we all just got a bunch of blue tape, and if anybody had any at home, they would bring it. And we did this by, I think VIP and Limelight had gone into the venue, and everybody waiting out in the lines for the doors to open, we sort of took the roles, and a few of us went around to the people behind us and sort of passed little pieces out. So we were texting, we were like, okay, how are we gonna do this? And we each got a section of the venue. And so me and my friend, we started walking around, passing out pieces of tape. It ended up turning out pretty good.
How did I make it work? I had school that day, so after school, me and the three girls that I was going with, we went to the venue, and there was already a line forming. So in the line, we started passing out these hearts. We went up to each individual person, and we were like, hey, we're doing a project during In Too Deep. What section are you in? And can you help us pass these out? So we started handing out hearts depending on where they were. We gave them their color. And as soon as we got in, me, the three girls I was going with, and the girl that was doing this with me, we were the original, like, you know, everything's gonna be. She was really helping me with ideas and stuff like that. So we met up, but she had VIP. So we met up after she was done with VIP. She was in the balcony and I was in orchestra one. So I had the red hearts. I had red, orange, yellow, green, and she had blue and purple. So me, the three girls that I was with, and her decided to go around to the people that were around us, and we were like, hey, will you please help us pass these out? We have to get them out before openers start. And a lot of them were all like, yeah, of course, you know, we really want to see this succeed. So we sat them on the arms of the chairs, the hearts, and we got them out. I loved seeing that. I loved seeing that people loved the project, loved what we were doing for the boys. And yeah, and at the end of the song, I'm pretty sure it was Daniel. Daniel said, "Your all's lights are very beautiful." And I felt accomplished in what I had done. I felt that the hard work that I had done for months was completed, and I did what I really, really, really had worked hard on. Fan project was so fun to do, and I would do it again in a heartbeat, even though it was kind of stressful and I didn't think I was gonna get it done in time because we started it after the tour had already started. But it was so fun, and I really hope that I can do it again.
So we showed up at the venue super early after countless hours of printing signs and writing on signs and promoting it. So we spent hours and hours printing signs and doing it at work or school, or her mom did some at work. And we got hundreds of signs and brought them to the venue, got there super early. And every single person that showed up to the venue, we'd go around and hand out a sign to them, make sure they all had them. And then when it came time for us to check into VIP, we gave them to one of our other friends who was just in GA, who then handed them out to everyone else in the lineup. After VIP was over, we were waiting at Barricade, and I just remember I was literally like screaming out to people like, who has a sign, who still needs a sign? And for me, like, that's like, you know, I'm not someone who like, I don't like making phone calls.
Neither of us like talking to people, though.
We both are very keep to ourselves kind of people, but in situations like this, for some reason, we will talk to anybody about anything.
Different side
like,
comes out.
We go and we make sure every single person does a sign and that they all know what's going on. And I was literally standing there like, who needs a sign? Does everyone have a sign? Does everyone know what's going on? Yeah. Just like at the front of the barricade, literally yelling at people to make sure everyone knew what was going on.
I think it's different too when it's a fan project, because then you're talking to people who all like the same kind of stuff.
Yeah, we all kind of understand the same thing. We all have that
people
common ground.
People aren't going to judge you for it. They're like, oh, that's such a cool idea. Yeah. The boys are going to love it. And then we did one for the 8 Letters tour.
We got hundreds and hundreds of signs.
There was so many, because we had asked a couple of other people to help us, and some mums printed some off, and they all brought them and gave them to us when we got to the venue, so we had lots.
So we ended up bringing probably like close to 500 signs inside the venue, so anybody who had printed them at home, plus all the signs that we brought and brought them from Canada. We brought a lot. We brought them inside the venue with thank you, John. Like, this wouldn't have been possible without John. John and the venue were so super helpful. They let us bring the signs in and then let us go into the actual like venue area earlier. So we went and put a sign on every single chair on the floor section. We didn't quite have enough for everybody, but we had at least everybody on the floor had a sign, plus more people spread out on top. So hundreds and hundreds of people were holding up signs inside the venue. So when Taking You started playing and I just looked around, and it was just like incredible to see everybody like take part in it. And yeah.
We totally keep doing
it. Oh yeah.
We'll probably do another one next tour.
Yeah.
How did you meet your internet friend?
I met my internet best friends on Instagram and Twitter, but mostly Instagram, but I met them through Why Don't We.
So I met my internet best friend through my TikTok account. I have a Why Don't We and Evan TikTok account, and she commented on one of my posts and was like, hey, let's be friends. I was like, oh yeah, sure. So we started DMing through TikTok, and then I got her Snap, and then I got her phone number, and we started FaceTiming, and it's been about 8 months. We're closer than ever, and it's really great.
How did you meet your internet friends? I made mine through this group chat on Instagram, where we started talking like every day and FaceTiming.
On Twitter, I've actually started an account that was personal, but then I changed it to like a stan account. I've made a lot of friends through the group, which I'm really thankful for.
How I met my internet friends was that I joined Twitter 2016, and then in the beginning of 2018 I became a Limelight. So just in a few months I had gotten to know so many new people, and I'd been added to this new group chat and everything. And then in May 2018 I went to my first Why Don't We show, and I got to know so many new people on that show. And then suddenly I had people from the internet and people from the show that I had gotten to know. And today I have a lot of internet friends just because of Why Don't We, and I'm in a lot of group chats with people I could never imagine a life without.
Have you ever met any of your internet friends in real life?
I have met two of my internet friends online. I met them at one of their concerts, actually, and it was amazing meeting them.
I am very thankful that I have met lots of my internet friends in real life. It's so insane to me to think that there are so many people in this world and so many people that support Why Don't We. Because we all share the same love for Why Don't We, that made us become close. And I have seriously met some of my best friends and people I will always cherish. Because these five boys, I now know people that I will know for the rest of my life and I will always cherish for the rest of my life. My best friends, most of them I've met because of these five boys, and I don't know what I would do without them or the boys.
I've met lots of my internet friends in real life. I met her on the internet, and now I see her all the time.
Literally, I see her every single day.
But I've met so many of my internet friends in real life. A lot of my internet friends from Australia I have now met.
Like, I met her through a group chat, and we made this group chat with a bunch of different Limelights in Vancouver, and little did I know she lived down the street from me, and now we're literally best friends. I don't know, it's crazy to think that like we probably would have never met, but like we had the same coach growing up.
Yeah,
like,
we had the same coach.
Like, our parents were to the same Christmas party, but we never would have met if it wasn't for the boys.
She played soccer or softball with people I played soccer with.
Yeah, it's like
we knew people at each other's schools.
No, I have not. Me and my internet best friend live 11 and a half hours away from each other. She lives in Florida, I live in Arkansas. So next weekend I was gonna go to Florida and just have a good time and maybe meet up with her, but she was going out of town, and so we couldn't meet up, and I was really sad. We were planning on meeting up this summer, and meeting her for the first time, and I'm beyond excited because she's such a great person.
I met a super sweet girl called Clara at a Why Don't We concert in Copenhagen. It was the best day of my life, and we hung out before meet and greet and like after the concert, but we couldn't hang out that much because like we had school the next day. We're gonna meet up in the upcoming week, I think, because of the holidays and stuff like that. So I'm so excited.
Yes, I've met one, and I'm gonna be meeting some more at Jingle Ball. And it's really cool because one of the girls in the group chat is actually going to my high school next year, which is crazy. And I'm super excited because the first time we're gonna meet is over Why Don't We, and then we're gonna go to school together. Like, that's just crazy.
I've never met any of them because we all live in different states and different countries. And plus, I'm only 14, so I can't go on planes to go to the different states and different countries.
Yes, I have met a lot of my internet friends at the two Why Don't We shows I've been to. I remember the last show I went to, October 6th, 2019. I went to both the VIP line, the Limelight line, and the general admission ticket line just to meet all of my friends that was at the show. This summer, 2019, me and my family went to Spain, and then one day, me and my internet friend from Spain decided to meet, and we did. We met at the beach, and we blasted Why Don't We music all over the beach, and it was so much fun because that was my first time meeting a Limelight friend outside my country.
I actually have at the San Jose show, which was the beginning of the year, March 24. I was in a group chat of people that were going to the show too, and on the day of the show, I actually met them for the first time, and to this day, we're still close.
What makes internet friends different from friends in real life?
I think the difference between internet friends, like having them, is that they like understand you, you know, it's like something different from the world. Like you're talking to people who have the same interest as you, and sometimes they just understand you more, or you're willing to tell them more than you are with your real friends.
They actually like can connect with you, they understand you. Like there's people in real life that I know that like Why Don't We, but also understand where I'm coming from. But then there's the friends in real life that aren't like Why Don't We fans, but most of my internet best friends are Why Don't We fans, so they know exactly where I'm coming from.
The difference definitely is that like they relate to you. Like many of my friends doesn't understand how I'm feeling with these boys because of like they doesn't feel the same about the boys or another artist. Like they don't understand how it is being such a big fan of someone. When you meet people that feel the same way as you, yeah, you just like start talking and relate to each other.
I would say internet friends understand you more since they relate to you more than in real life friends. I feel like they don't really have much interest as you.
I think what makes internet friends different from in real life friends is that internet friends are always there. You can just open your phone and start to talk to someone because you know that someone is always active. And you can make so many internet friends. You can always talk about Why Don't We with them because you know that you both like them. That's hard to do with in real life friends because you know that if you talk too much about Why Don't We, no one is gonna care because they don't know how it is to like Why Don't We. But an internet friend always know how you feel and they know how it is to like them because they like them just as much as you do.
I see my friends in real life every single day, 8 hours at school, and I see them on like a routine basis. It's not anything new or special. I only get to talk to my internet friends through FaceTime every other day for 30 minutes, so that time I have with them is extra special. Also, my internet best friends and I have basically one thing in common, and that's Why Don't We and Evan. So we get to talk about that, and I get to talk about that with them. And I can't talk about that stuff with my regular friends because none of them are really Limelights or anything.
Why do you think parents worry about making friends on the internet?
Safety. That's the number one thing. It's all about safety, and I get where the parents are coming from, and if I were a parent, I probably would be the same way. I'm happy that I have parents that understand and know where I'm coming from because they have internet best friends too. So I'm happy that I have parents who let me talk to people on the line because I know not all parents are like that.
I definitely think they worry about it because like you're their child, like they need to protect you, of course, and keep you safe. But when you meet these people through a screen, you can never be sure that they're 100% legit. And that's of course also why that you gotta have a parent if you wanna meet them, because or just another person, because like you like need to be safe in a way, and it isn't safe to meet and like people you have never met before without someone else.
I feel like parents worry about me making it to your friends because they don't really know you and you don't really know them. And it could be a stranger talking to you. Most cases, that's not really it. My parents are actually fond of me having internet friends because I relate to them more than anyone else.
So I think parents worry about their kids talking to people on the internet is because they think we're gonna be talking to an 80-year-old man when we think we're talking to a 15-year-old girl who likes the same people as us. And so they don't want us to get catfished by those people and get our feelings hurt when we find out that we are thinking that we are talking to a teenage-year-old girl the same age as us, but we are talking to an 80-year-old man. And so I understand that our parents will think that way, but if we are old enough to be on social media, then we should know that people will get catfished and that we should know that we should be aware that we might get catfished and we will know what to do and what not to do in order to not get catfished.
I think that parents worry about a child making friends on the internet because you can't know who it is that you are talking to. You can't know who it is behind the screen. It can be this sweet 15 years old girl, but it can also be this 50 years old man pretending to be that sweet girl. And I have met a few people that are pretending to be someone else, but I have always figured that out pretty fast. And before I meet someone for the first time, I always make sure that the person I'm gonna meet is 100% legit.
So there's really bad people in this world, and I just think parents want us to be safe and to make sure we're not talking to any of those bad people, and they want us talking to good people who are gonna make sure we're making the right decisions and not bad influences on us. I don't think they want us talking to those bad people, and I think they just want us to stay safe and not make dumb decisions.
How do you ensure that your internet friends are real?
You have to like get to know them and then FaceTime them, because most of the time you know they're legit once you see their face. If you are just texting them, you don't know if they're trying to stalk you, find where you live. You gotta make sure you are safe as can be and first get to know them, then FaceTime them. Don't just go from right to FaceTiming them, because that's probably not the best idea and the safest idea.
How do you make sure the people you're talking to on the internet are legit? So basically what I did is when I first started talking to my IBF, my internet best friend, is I like did a whole bunch of background checks on her by like going through her Instagram account, and I went through her friend's Instagram account, and I went through their tagged posts and make sure she was a legitimate person, and I paid attention to every little detail she said. I paid attention to when her birthday was, her lane, and like see if she posted anything about it on her Instagram, and she did, and everything like went in line in the right place, and like everything was like added up, and I found out she was like a legitimate person and she was like a good person, and I'm so happy I met her, and I never would have met her without the Why Don't We Boys and Evan, and it's just such a great experience, and the Why Don't We Boys have changed me for the better.
You can't actually make sure that the people you are talking to on internet are 100% legit until you meet them, but my best tip is to FaceTime them. And that can also be really fun. I have tried it a few times and it's really fun, trust me. If you don't want to FaceTime someone or if you're too shy, you can always add each other's Snapchats and send video snaps to each other. And that can also be really fun. Instead of just texting all the time, you can talk to each other.
What were your initial thoughts on your son or daughter having internet friends?
I was a little bit nervous, but once I met them, I think it's fabulous. She's met some really great girls and gals. It's a good thing.
I was very concerned about my child meeting people over the internet because you never know who you're meeting. But after hearing about these people and after meeting some of these people, they are all actually very nice. But you still have to be concerned about who you're meeting over the internet because you never know who it is. You could be meeting some psycho, so you really got to be careful. But so far, she's got lots of great friends there, so she's a smart kid, so I trust what she does.
When I found out my daughter had online friends, I wasn't particularly happy about it because there's a lot of people out there that are not genuine. We went and met one of her online friends, and they were the person who she said she was.
What are your thoughts on your child going to concerts?
Why not? It's a lifetime experience, an experience of a lifetime. I used to like boy bands. New Kids on the Block, love them. Joey McIntyre, my heartthrob. Backstreet Boys. So now I'm seeing my daughter do the same thing as me. It's fantastic.
I like my daughter going to concerts and meeting her friends there. She meets a lot of friends at concerts. It's a great way to meet all different kinds of people. And you know what? If you enjoy the concert, you might as well go while you can. I'd have done that when I was younger as well. I still enjoy going to concerts, so enjoy. And then meeting the favorite band. And if you use your own money, you might as well buy meet and greet and everything else. You know what? As long as you're not spending my money and it's your money, go for it.
I took my daughter to see Why Don't We in concert twice, and they were pretty good. I'm not a fan of theirs, but I thought they were really good, and my daughter really enjoyed it, and we'll probably go back and see them again.
What is your opinion on the Why Don't We Boys?
Well, the Why Don't We Boys, what can I say about those guys? Wow, they are some Why Don't We Boys. They're pretty good in concert. They're kind of cute. The girls, yeah, well, they love them. And I guess a lot of the mums too, so Why Don't We? You rock.
As for the Why Don't We Boys, my daughter met them and she thought they were absolutely fantastic. I saw them through the window and they made her very happy, which makes me very happy as a parent.
What are your opinions on the Why Don't We Boys?
I like them. They're lots of fun. We saw them at the fair in Paso Robles and they were just down to earth, kind of cool, had fun going on all the rides. That's all I gotta say.
They have truly been one of the funnest, most humble, kind, determined, passionate, and caring group of guys. We started in Seattle taking you tour. And we have just continued to follow them ever since. You cannot help but adore their contagious behavior. And we are so excited to see where 2020 is gonna take you. And we cannot wait to share the journey with you. Take care, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. Hope to see you soon.
Have you or would you let your child travel for a show?
We travelled quite a long way to go see the Why Don't We concert. We went to Manchester, which is about 2 to 2.5 hours from where we live. So it was quite a long journey for us. We ended up stopping in a hotel, which cost a lot of money, but it was well worth it. And my daughter enjoyed herself, and I was pleased with that, and we will be going to see them again.
Have you let your child travel to meet Why Don't We?
I certainly have, and I certainly would again. Not only have I met good friends like their parents, but Chloe's also met really good friends as well.
Would I let my child to go travel to see Why Don't We? Well, I have. She uses her own money and her own judgment. She's pretty smart, so why would I not let her go travel and see the band she wants to see? As long as she wants to do that and is in control and takes care of herself and everything else, we're all good. Why don't we? You rock still.
What makes being a Limelight worth it?
Well, let's just say it's definitely worth it. So I've been a Limelight for about 2.5 years. And let's just say it's been quite a journey. I've made so many incredible friendships. I can call these people my best friends. Just because I started supporting a man band. I have like friendships that I know are gonna last for ever, hopefully. I have friends from Texas, Washington, Michigan. I have a friend from England, she's amazing. And you can just talk to these people about what makes you happiest the most. They like totally understand and they relate and they'll just be like, oh my God, yeah, like, ah. Yeah, it's literally the best feeling ever. Because I feel like when you talk to your like friends that you go to school with about Why Don't We, they like don't understand. Like, they don't know what it feels like to be this happy and like love something this much. I feel like when you talk to them about it, they don't like understand or they don't relate, so they don't really care, which kind of sucks, not gonna lie. But when you have Limelight friends, they like totally understand and they like are like, yes, it's definitely worth it because you will make some amazing friends and it's incredible because they give like the best advice and they're always just there for you. And you know, they're not gonna tell anyone anything because, well, they can't because they live so far, which really sucks. But yeah, it sucks that they live so far, but it's life. And hopefully I get to meet all these amazing people soon. Yeah, my friend from Texas, Nadia, her and I always go to Why Don't We shows together. Like,
I drive down to Dallas, Texas. I drove down there twice, and she came up to Kansas twice. We kind of experienced it all together, which is amazing. Like, when you go to, like, concert, I feel like it's fun to be there by yourself and just, like, with your mom, and she's just chilling, right? But when you have a friend to experience it all with you and be like, oh my god, did you see Daniel just, like, look at me? That's happened multiple times to me. I'm convinced that Daniel stares into my soul. But yeah, it's kind of the most amazing feeling ever. We're all here for the same reason, and that's to support and love the guys.
Being in limelight is worth it because whenever I'm having a bad day at school, I can always come home and look at their social media and laugh at the random stuff that they post, because they can post some random things. I've also met one of my best friends because I was in limelight. And that makes it all worth it, because now I met someone who I can actually connect with.
Watching the boys grow and being able to do what they love totally makes worth being in limelight. It's not just a fandom, it's like a family. And we're always like supporting each other, and the boys' music brings everyone together. We have a constant love and support for the boys.
What makes being in limelight worth it? To me, it has been meeting new friends. I've gotten to meet so many people through these boys. I've met people at concerts, and you know, I've stayed in touch with these people.
What makes being a limelight worth it to me is the family and friends that you create through the fandom. It feels like such a tight-knit community. It just is such a nice and warm, welcoming community. The instant that I became in the fandom or started to make friends in the fandom, I literally felt like I'd been there forever.
I think that being a limelight is worth it because their music is so amazing, and I love listening to it all the time. I also love their positivity. Every single interview I watch with them, it makes me smile or it makes me laugh, because they're always so happy, and it makes me happy too.
What makes being a limelight worth it is definitely the family you build, because you're surrounded by people who love the same band as you, and so you're going to get to know them and make friends with them and build a family with them.
I think the fact that I can meet so many people and make so many friends with it. I would go to the ends of the world just to make my friends happy. Just like I would go to the ends of the world just to make the boys happy, because they truly are amazing human beings. I made so many friends at concerts because of them. I made my best friend.
You can make friends from all over the world, and you can just talk about stuff. You can talk about life. You can talk about the boys. And I think that that's a great thing.
Being a limelight is worth it because you get to make new friends and build new relationships. So when you're going through a hard time, you always have someone there for you. And you never know, they might make you feel better with a "Why Don't We Go?" They always have a song for whatever mood you're in. If you're sad, they have a song to lift you up. And if you're happy, they have a song to make you keep feeling good.
What makes the boys different from other artists?
What makes the boys different from other artists is they are still like right now, they're still on their rise. And I feel like they really connect with their fans really well. Really before when they were starting out with their careers, right now as they're building up. And I feel even when they become like one of the world's biggest boy bands, pretty much, they're still gonna have that connection. That really close connection with their fans. They make every single fan that they talk to and interact with feel special. They are the only artists that I know that try to remember your name. Like any other artist, they're just like, oh yeah, but they'll like be like, oh, I know you, like I know that I know you from somewhere, like what's your name? Or they'll know your name, which for a lot of artists who meet like thousands of people a day, to me that's crazy.
What makes the boys different from any other artist? They actually care about their fans.
I think something unique about the boys is that they're constantly releasing new music. And this year, they're releasing one song every month. And before that, they released like 5 EPs a year. And because of that, they keep their fans engaged and keep growing and growing.
They're genuine people. Will be real with you. I mean, I've never gotten to meet them, but I can tell from videos how sweet and how real they are with you. You know, because they are people. They're not, just because they're famous doesn't make them, they're human. And they're unlike other artists who will put a face, they'll be someone different than who they really are. And these boys won't do that. And that's honestly what I like about them, because they will be themselves no matter how they feel, no matter how tired or stressed out or, you know, bored they are. They will be real with you no matter what. You know, they always smile at the end of the day, and that's what I genuinely
love about them, and that's how I find them different from other artists.
The boys are different from other artists because they always have a new sound and they always have something new. When they are in an interview, you know they're being themselves. Most artists put on a mask whenever they're in front of a camera, but us Limelines know the boys are always being themselves. And they're cuter.
I think that the boys are different from other artists because they're always so happy and they really care about their fans. I mean, I don't think I've ever seen an interview of them being sad or depressed or anything like that. They're always trying to bring positive into the world and make everyone else happy. They also, every single concert that they have a meet and greet. It's kind of a way of giving back to their fans, which I really think is cool. I also like that every single one of their voices is different and is so good. Like some other bands, they have like two singers that are good and the rest are like backup, but no, every single one of them is good and they all mesh together and they sound so amazing together. I love you.
What makes the boys differ from other artists? One, they're much more attractive. I also think that their like feelings for their fans, like they really love us, you know, and they care for us a lot. And like the fact that they've stopped their shows multiple times because they see that fan passed out or something. Not all artists do that. I feel like most artists aren't as like close to their fans and like they don't connect like we do with the boys. I also feel like they're more humble and they really show that they're human, which is also amazing because like they don't let their fame get in the way of like their normal lives. Let's see, 2019, I don't think they've had a break, maybe like a month break added up together. But they do. I feel like they work a lot harder than most artists. They were on tour all year and in the studio, and yeah, they just got back from their Asia tour and their Australia, and now they're doing Jingle Ball, which is, I can't even imagine, that'd be so stressful. I feel like they definitely care a lot more.
Like they said that they don't want to be seen like they're stuck in a cage, that they like they hold meet and greets all the time. They're really sweet to their fans. The boys generally care about us as like they're part of their family, and they don't treat us like we're just other fans.
They're so down to earth and they can just, they're so real. They didn't change or anything, and you can actually bond with them. They're open for relationships with fans. I think that that's a great thing that they have, because a lot of artists don't really involve their fans that much.
How have the boys impacted your life?
The boys have impacted my life a lot. When I joined the fandom about in the beginning of this year, I was kind of in a rough spot. When I joined the fandom, I met an instant group of friends that helped me out of that dark place and helped me feel happier with myself. I hadn't really found any real boy bands that I had been into since One Direction, and so it just brought back my love of boy bands and my love of all of that stuff. And so it really made me really happy again, because One Direction and things like that made me really happy, and I love boy bands. So getting to do all that stuff again and just meeting so many amazing friends through this whole process has been amazing. Like, some of these friends I know are gonna be there when I have my first kids, when I'm at my wedding. Like, I'm literally moving in with one of these friends that I have met next year in LA. Like, that is the impact that these friendships have had. And the community around Limelights and the Why Don't We fandom is just absolutely amazing.
The boys have really helped me, because if I feel sad, I listen to them and they instantly make me feel happy again and I forget why I was sad. And also, the boys really care about their fans, so if I'm sad, I know that they'll be there for me and make me feel like happy again.
To be honest, these boys have helped me so much. Going through my family problem, listening to their music gave me so much relief. Let me know that there are people that care about me in this world. Their music has really helped me. When I get stressed, when I get sad, I listen to it. When I'm happy, I listen to it. Because their music makes me happy. Their music makes me who I am. And I will always be grateful for what they did. No matter what, they put a smile to my face every day, no matter how my day is going. No matter if I'm having the worst day. No matter if I'm having a crazy day. When I see them on my feed, on TikTok, Instagram, whatever it is, they make me happy. They make me smile. They make me love myself for who I am. And I thank them every day for that.
So
last year, I was dealing with a lot of bullying, and I got diagnosed with anxiety really bad. I remember just one day going on YouTube and just searching up Why Don't We, and I just like listened to all their songs. Just it helped me calm down a lot. And then recently, I found out one of my best friends committed suicide. He was always there for me. And a few days later, I went to go see Why Don't We at the Jingle Ball. I knew that it wouldn't be the same knowing that my best friend wouldn't be there, but they still made me smile. I still had an amazing time. And I know no matter what, that Limelights will always be there for me if I ever need them. Thank you, Why Don't We.
Something about me. I have really bad panic attacks and like I have really bad depression, and their boys have helped me through that. Whenever I have a panic attack, I'll like tell Echo Dot, hey, Echo Dot, play Why Don't We? And there's like shuffling songs by Why Don't We? And like I'll start playing that, and like I'll be able to calm down my breathing, and like I'll be able to like stay calm when I'm listening to them. Just by their music, they have helped me make me feel like I'm not alone, because that's kind of what happens when you have depression. And I've gone, and I know like I'm not alone, but sometimes I don't like process that. You can ask for like a better people to follow, or like a better band, because I genuinely love the boys more than anything in the world, because they've helped me with so much. Whenever I listen to their music, I don't feel like I'm a groupie, like, or I feel like I'm listening to my friends sing and following their dreams.
How have the boys made an impact on my life? Oh, okay, let's just say like two and a half years ago, I was very sad, and it kind of sucked because I am a pretty happy person, and when I was sad for literally no reason, I was like, what is going on? But then I met Why Don't We, and I was like, whoa, I'm gonna check that out. So I did, and here I am today. Like, so I listen to their music when I'm sad, and I watch their interviews, and they never fail to make me laugh, which makes me feel so much better. And then they also have helped lead me to some amazing people. Like, I know for a fact when I'm sad, I hit up my friends, and I'm like, whoa, yo, what's up? And they always help me. And I love that. And I've also kind of gained some TikTok clout because of them. So follow me at Kasiah Out Richmond. I definitely 100% recommend being Limelight because it is the best experience ever. And I love the boys and I love you. Have a good day.
They really impacted my life because I just wasn't happy a few years ago. And they really made me realize that living is worth it. And I just want them to know that they impact a lot of people's lives and they can save a lot of lives just like mine, and I really wanted to get that in the world, so thank you.
The boys have helped me get through difficult times in my life. Their music, interviews, and videos have helped me feel better in dark times. The boys have changed my life. They've given me so many new friends. People I thought I'd never talk to are now some of my best friends because of them. Thank you, Why Don't We, for everything you've given me.
To me, the boys mean everything. They've helped me through some of the worst and the best times of my life. Made some of the closest friends I've ever had, but like true friends as well. When I joined the fandom back in October 2016, after the release of Taking You, I joined a group chat called Limelight Angels, and we were so close, and we're still really close now.
What's something you would say to someone who doesn't understand what it's like to be a Limelight?
For someone who doesn't understand what it's like to be a Limelight, I would say it's like a family. We're all in it together. We all have the same idea of supporting these five guys. That's our main goal. And at the end of the day, we're all striving to love these five guys as much as we can.
I feel like a lot of people judge people and make comments and say hurtful things to people because they're a fangirl or, you know, whatever their stereotype, like, picture of a fangirl is, and they assume that's what they are. And I feel like they make all these comments and like try and like tear them down and like make fun of them in a way, but like put yourself in their shoes first and realize the whole aspect of everything before you start doing that, because in reality, like, a lot of things that are said or are assumed aren't true, and there's so much more to like being a fangirl or Limelight or whatever than people think. And it's not just about, you know, screaming, crying over an artist or listening to the music. It's so much more about meeting friends. Like, the amount of like internet friends videos that I literally see online every single day of fans meeting and reuniting and just seeing either their friends at concerts or, you know, meeting up and going to Disney or meeting up and going to wherever. And like, it's incredible to see all these people like meet up with each other and become so genuinely happy They're meeting these people who make them happy, who are some of their best friends, who live wherever else, but they came together because of an artist, and it's something so special and so unique, and I feel like people don't really understand that.
The one question that I get is, like, why are you spending so much time on people who don't really, you know you, or don't really necessarily, like, feel the same way about you? And I think it's a sense of unity, and you kind of, the fandom is a little bit of, like, a home, and it's family, and it's a safe place, it's a little bit of an escape, and it's like, take a pause from real life and just talk to your friends. Really nice to feel like somebody is, like, kind of like you, and it's, again, it's really nice to feel like you kind of have a family that's not biological, or it's not somebody who's directly in your inner circle, it's somebody who you may have met online, or you met at a concert, or, yeah, I just, it's something that is really out of the ordinary. It's the out of the ordinary family, and I think, like, it's really, really just sweet, and it's really nice.
What I would say to someone who doesn't understand what it's like to be a limelight is, like, a lot of people think that being, like, a fangirl is a bad thing, but it's not. We take away so much stuff from being a fangirl that can help us in, like, our day-to-day life. We're super organized because of it, because we help organize fan projects. You don't judge before you actually see what it's like. A lot of, like, teenage fans would go out and buy all of the jerseys from a football team they like and go to multiple games. It's the same kind of thing. It's just for a different reason.
You should just let us be like we are. Like, don't try to change us. It's not possible. We might be a bit different than some other people, but just let us be us, and don't try to put us, like, in an other segment, because that's not where we belong. We're really delicate, and we should do whatever we want to do. You should just let us be us, because that's what we're best, and it's not helping to try to change a single one of us.
To anyone who is watching this who still doesn't understand what it's like to be a limelight or fangirl or boy, I just want to say that it is something that has changed my life and so many other people. And it's not all just about stalking boy bands and chasing after them and harassing them. It's nothing like that at all. It's like a family, being a part of something that everyone is there for the same reason and supports the same people, and we all support each other. And it's crazy that five boys can do that, bring so many people together, and they have shown me and brought me to my best friends. They have showed me what it's like to be confident and to be myself. And that's something that I feel like a lot of people aren't able to do. They don't have the platform to share what they want to share like the boys do. Just the fact that the boys are themselves all the time and are goofy and funny and caring, and it's just so inspiring, and it helps me be a better version of myself to see that they can do it so I can do it.
What do you hope someone's going to take away from this?
The thing that I really want, the people who are watching this, the thing that I really want them to take away from this is that we kind of have, every limelight has a story, and it's not just like we're not all crazy, and we're not all like screaming all the time and freaking out. We all have, I think, like, people categorize some people as, like, fangirls, and there's nothing more to them. Puts faces behind that and, like, the story, and it's just, I want people to realize that they're not alone, and that there's this family here for you.
Something that I would hope anyone who watches this takes away from it is just how powerful music can be, and how it can connect people, and connect the artist to the fans, and the fans to each other. I hope it shows just how passionate and dedicated fans are, and how much love and support they have for the artists.
Something that I hope you guys take away from this video is that limelights are family. We all are here for each other, and we're all here for the same reason. And if you ever need somebody, we're all here for you. The boys are here for you, and I'm just so thankful to have all the limelights in my life.
What I hope what others take from this video is that they hopefully understand that not every fangirl is like this girl you see screaming in front of a famous artists are just like fainting in front of them, because that's not what we actually are. Like, some girls might be like this, but not everyone. And hopefully this video gives some other people some understanding that being a fangirl is much more than just like going to a concert or just like crushing on some famous people. We do like so much stuff for all of them. We got like the best friends mostly because of this one band, and I hope that other people see that not everyone of this fandom, or like not every single fangirl, is just like this little screaming fangirling girl. It's much more.
For anybody who is in a limelight, I feel like this fandom and this family is so much different than other fandoms, in the sense of I feel like we're all so close and we can all rely on each other. And that's kind of where I feel like that's what I want to be in this fandom, is someone as an older fan. I want to be someone that other limelights can look up to and go to for not only things with the boys or things with tour, but life in general, just because I've experienced so many things and gone through so much that I want younger fans to be able to come to me and just know that I am their shoulder to rely on if they need someone. And I feel like in general, that's kind of how this fandom is. And that's something that I haven't found in other fandoms, because I feel like in other fandoms, a lot of people are competing with each other. And I feel like in this fandom, we're always so like uplifting, and we're always so excited like when another fan gets noticed, or like another fan has like a really positive experience. We always hype each other up, and I really love that about us. And I feel like for anyone who is like on the fence about getting into the fandom, or like is a little unsure if they're gonna be welcomed because they're like not an OG, I feel like you don't have anything to worry about, because everyone is so welcoming. And I just think in general, like, the Limelight family is such a great place to be, and it's very loving. So if you're gonna take anything away from this video, I would take away that the Limelight fandom is the best fandom out there, and we would love to have you a part of our family.
What I would want to be taken away from this documentary, one thing that I've always wanted people to know, is that fangirls aren't crazy. I would say to not stereotype us. Like, I think the stereotype for a fangirl is like we're insane and we stalk the boys and blah blah blah. We're not insane, and our goal is not to look crazy. It's to support the boys as much as we can and to love them unconditionally. We're not psychos.
How have the boys impacted your life?
As you can see, I'm a very smiley person, but to not go into too much detail, I used to not be very, very smiley, and I go through a lot mentally. It's kind of hard to sometimes just like be happy and have that escape, and I think the boys have really just been that escape for me. You know, the first time that I heard like Made For, like, it to me, I really took it as like, sometimes like you just have to live life, and like there were days, and still to this day, like, I didn't go a single day without like listening to Just to See You Smile. And they kind of made me feel really, not warm and fuzzy inside, but just like really happy. It's just, they made my life better.
The boys have impacted my life in so many ways. I've met friends, so many friends because of them. 99% of my friends I've made through the boys. I've traveled to so many places I never thought I'd get to go to, and I've got to go back to so many different places that I have been to before that I'd loved and made friends there before. And because of the boys, I got to go back and see them again. The positivity has also hugely impacted my life, just seeing the way they interact with fans, and all of the positivity and kindness that they spread through their social medias has always been something that's super special and important to me.
Being in a fandom, especially Limelights, is very special because you get to share your love for the band with so many other people, boys and girls, young and old, from all over the world. You get to be excited for all the boys' successes together. You get to make friends within the fandom, and that is also one of the ways that Why Don't We has impacted my life the most, because I've met so many of my friends through them, because they like Why Don't We as well, and we've met through going to the concerts, listening to the music together.
The boys have absolutely impacted my life. They've led me to some of the best friends I've ever had, and they've also changed the way I think. They have taught me to not take myself so seriously and to not take the world so seriously. I naturally overthink everything, and to watch the boys on stage or to watch them in an interview, it's taught me that life is short and we can't take everything so seriously, and we just need to have fun with life and be ourselves. And that's something that I constantly work on every single day with self-confidence, but I think the boys are helping tremendously with my self-confidence.
If I could explain how much the boys have impacted my life, this video, my part alone, would be like 10 minutes long. I cannot even put into words how much they've impacted my life, because I think of myself like a few years ago when I first found the boys. I knew all of these things that I kind of wanted to do in the back of my head and never really knew how to do them. And I feel like I've really grown with the boys because I have been there since they were super small.
Because I really need it. I ain't afraid of how you got me.
And like only had a few hundred people at their shows. Now I'm still with them now that they have a couple thousand people at their shows.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? They sold this out. They sold this out. I'm going to cry.
And just watching them really chase and follow their dreams is really inspiring to me, because now I know that what I want to do isn't that crazy, and it's because of them that I feel like I can achieve my goals and achieve my dreams. Because if these boys from, you know, Pennsylvania and Minnesota and Texas, if they can do it, a girl from Wisconsin can too. And so I just feel like without them, I would still be wanting to do all these things with social media and music and just never really going for it, because no one around here does that. And I feel like because of them, that's I can make it happen, and it has been happening, and it's literally because of the boys. And I've met so many people through the boys. Overall, the boys just bring together so many different people from all over the world, and we've created such a strong family. Their impact that they have on everybody is incredible.
They have just done so much for me, and I can't thank them enough, and I want to do everything I can to support them and to help them live their dreams, because seeing them happy really makes me happy and really inspires me to keep going, so yeah.
If you had 30 seconds to say something to the boys, what would you say?
Something I would say to the boys is thank you. You have helped me through so much in my life. I love you guys. I will always love you guys. I will always be here to support you. Thank you for everything that you've done.
Thank you. You wouldn't be where you are without us. Some of us wouldn't be here without you. So like, just thank you. And I love you guys. You're always loved. You're always cared for.
What I can say for the boys is like, I want to thank you for everything you've done for me. Like, even though you probably don't know what you've done for me, but you gave me so much joy and so much happiness. I gained so many friends because of you. And I have to say, I'm living my best life because of you. I started to traveling like around the world just to see you. I made my decision to go to America, live in a completely different country for 1 year. Just like to see new things, and I don't regret any second, and I love you. I love you, and thank you so much for everything.
If I could tell the boys anything, it would honestly just be how proud I am, how much I admire them for all the hard work, and how it's been such an amazing journey seeing them grow and become more and more successful, and just how much I love them.
Boys, if you're watching this, I just want you to know that I am so unbelievably proud of you and how far you guys have come. You are such an inspiration to me and so many other people, and just keep doing your thing. We are so excited to see where you guys take things, and we're excited to hear new music and to see what you guys have in store.
If I could say something to the boys in under 30 seconds, I would just say thank you. Thank you for giving me reasons to travel to different places. Thank you for being super positive always.
If I could say something to the boys, I would really just say thank you. Thank you for them being themselves always. Thank you for being a positive influence in my life. They have literally changed my life so much and introduced me to so many new people and brought me to so many new places. Let me have so many new experiences that I honestly would never have. I'm just really grateful for all the experiences that I have gotten in the last like year and a half, 2 years, and I can't wait to continue making new memories and continue meeting new people and traveling to new places. Just thank you, and I love you guys, and keep being you and keep doing your thing because it makes me happy and you make a lot of people happy, so thank you.
If I could say anything to the boys, it would be a big fat thank you. And I guess this is more towards Corbin in the sense of he's the one who gives the big plans speech, but that speech means everything to me because it just really hits home because I know that you really believe in us and want us to succeed the way that we believe in you and want you guys to succeed. So thank you, thank you, thank you to all of you.
How many of you guys are chasing your dreams? This is something about people. Every night there's been like a good cheer when that happens. It's so good. I want to say something to anybody in the crowd tonight who has a dream that they feel is maybe a little bit too big, or they feel like nobody believes in them, or what's the point, like, it's so far away kind of thing. And I want to start by saying that us five dudes were there at one point in our lives. And look what you all did for us. So first of all, thank you. But I want to pass on some lessons, I guess, that we learned along the way. And the first one and the most important one is work hard and dedicate time to perfecting whatever it is that you love. And number two, there's a saying, and it's a really, I think it's a pretty widely known saying that if you love what you do, you never work a day in your life. And we love what we do. And we get to do this every night, and it's the absolute craziest thing. Like, we never ever thought in our wildest dreams we thought that we would be here, but never did we ever think it would come true. But I want to say that it starts with you. It starts with each and every one of you, and you guys have to believe in yourselves before anyone will believe in you. And we learned that the hard way. But I just want to say, man, we have met so many of you guys just in meet and greets and out on the streets and just everywhere. And you guys have so many goals and aspirations, and it's really inspiring to us to hear all that every day because we get a chance to hopefully inspire you guys, which is what we love to do, and it's what we do it for. So I hope that we can continue to do that. And we started this year off with a motto, right? And that motto came out with the first song we dropped this year. Right? That song is called Big Plans. So I want to say, make some big plans for yourself.